we're talking trade, we're talking military. We just looked at some incredible anti-terrorism things that are being done here in conjunction with the United States. And the relationship is very, very strong. We really had a very good relationship.
They got President Trump moments ago face-to-face with British Prime Minister Theresa May in England.
All right, and they're going to have a big press conference in 2 hours. Meanwhile, the meeting comes after the president slammed Theresa May, indirectly kind of, over her plan for Brexit. So what does all this mean for U.S. relations with the U.K. and for Theresa May's future?
Here to react is former U.K. Independence Party leader and Fox News contributor and our friend Nigel Farage. Nigel, great to see you this morning.
Thank you.
What did you make of, you know, he had the interview with The Sun, and he was complaining about Theresa May, the soft exit from Brexit. He said that's not what he recommended. He said if she maintains close ties with the EU, then that lucrative U.S. trade deal is highly unlikely. He was praising Boris Johnson, saying he would be a good prime minister. What are your thoughts about all of this right before he's sitting down with the prime minister?
This intervention has come as a bombshell to the establishment here in London. They simply cannot believe it. And there's one particular phrase that they did not want to hear. And this is the killer line. It's when President Trump says, "This is not the Brexit that people voted for." Mm-hmm. Now, what he's referring to is a meeting of the UK cabinet a week ago today, where they agreed to water down Brexit so significantly that in fact we wouldn't be taking back control properly of our laws, we'd still be subject to a European court, we wouldn't have full border controls, and crucially for America, you know, Mrs. May's been telling Donald Trump, once we're done with Brexit, there'll be a lucrative free trade deal with the USA. Good for both of us. This document means that is now virtually impossible. So I think Trump's intervention is based on two things. And by the way, I wasn't surprised by it because I know how he and those in his administration feel on these issues.
Sure.
Number one, Trump believes in Brexit. He believes in a world of democratic nation states cooperating with each other, not globalist structures like the European Union. And number two, I think he feels that the U.S. administration has been very badly let down.
Mm-hmm. Well, you supported Brexit. Donald Trump supported Brexit. Theresa May did not support Brexit, and now she's had the on her hands trying to figure out how to do it. Do you think her time is limited now at 10 Downing Street? Is the meter running and maybe Boris Johnson's in next?
Do you know something? To put through something like Brexit, you know, to turn the ship of state around by 180 degrees, take back our independence, to do these things, you have to actually believe in it.
Right.
And Theresa May, as you point out, was a Remainer. Let's be frank, she's not up to the job. And if she stays as Prime Minister, we are not going to get the Brexit we voted for. The sense of betrayal in this country will be huge. And I very much hope that she's out of office before too long. And yeah, the favourite to succeed her is Boris. You know, and Boris did. And OK, it took a long time, but when it came down to the line, Boris did back Brexit.
Nigel, a couple of things. It seems as though behind the scenes, Theresa May did back the president behind closed doors at the NATO summit, and they do seem to be building a personal bond. What was it like when this story broke, do you think, during dinner yesterday?
I just can't imagine it. I mean, the scene, you know, Blenheim Palace, the birthplace of Winston Churchill. We had the big military bands on parade. The weather was beautiful. Theresa May was in her evening dress, met the president, and I can't imagine, as coffee was served, somebody whispering in Theresa May's ear, Prime Minister, there's something you ought to know. It must have been a very awkward moment.
I don't think you want to read the paper in the morning.
I'd love to be a fly on the wall now at the Prime Minister's country residence.
Nigel, real quick, I'm so disappointed in the British people protesting our president when they give President Erdogan of Turkey a pass, who jails his opponents and kills Kurds and took over that country. Where was the outrage when he visited? They were upset at our president.
Oh, look, we've had the Chinese premier, we've had the Saudi Arabian prince. We even, a few years ago, had Ceausescu, the dictator from Romania, and we gave him a state visit, and there were hardly any protests at all. This is ridiculous. And what is going on here is the liberal left press demonised Trump every single day, and unfortunately, Quite a few people believe that. But I have to say, protest is fine in a democracy, but to be flying this blimp, this kite of Donald Trump outside Parliament, how Sadiq Khan can have allowed that, I will never know.
Well,
you know, whatever anybody thinks of President Trump, America is our closest and most important ally in the world.
Right.
And frankly, I'm ashamed of that today.
All right. And looks like the blimp is holding a little smartphone to tweet. Nigel, thank you very much.